So students, we had discussed about the magnetic effect of current chapter in the last class. So what is, I had already discussed that this chapter deals with that when current is allowed to pass through a conductor, it produces magnetic field. So what is the definition of the magnetic field? It is the space around a magnet. It is the space, listen it very carefully, it is the space around a magnet or the space around a current carrying conductor in which the magnetic influence can be experienced. So the thing is that, what is magnetic field? Magnetic field is, if there is a magnet, we know that the magnetic field goes from the north pole to the south pole, fine. But if even if there is a conductor and the conductor is carrying current, then there will be a magnetic field around it. So regarding this, Biot and Savart, these were the two scientists who had done an experimental discovery, and they had postulated few statements. So what they are saying, they have taken that this one is a current carrying conductor. You can see XY is a current carrying conductor. They have taken a small current carrying element, that is DL. The current flowing through this XY is I, and here is the point P, which is at a distance smaller from this DL. I can repeat, XY is the current carrying conductor. I is the current flowing through this conductor. P is any point which is at a distance smaller from this small current carrying element. So this one is what? This one is a small current carrying element. Means this one is a small length, that is DL. So according to the Biot and Savart, what they are saying is that the amount of the magnetic field which will be experienced due to this small current carrying element is depending on what factors. dB is directly proportional to I, that is the amount of the current which is flowing through this conductor. dB is directly proportional to this small length, that is DL, that is the current carrying element what they have taken. dB is directly proportional to the sine of the angle between this current element and this point P. Which one is the current element? DL is the current element. And which one is the point P? Here is the point P. What is the angle subtended between them? That is theta. So dB is directly proportional to sine of that angle. So it is sine theta. And dB is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between this current element and this point P. Okay. So this one is postulated over here. dB is directly proportional to I. dB is directly proportional to DL. dB is directly proportional to sine theta, and dB is directly inversely proportional to the square of the distance. So if you are adding all these postulates, what we are getting? dB directly proportional to IDL sine theta divided by R square. The proportionality sign goes away, and over there it is coming mu naught by 4 pi. The value of mu naught by 4 pi is 10 to the power minus 7. This one is the value of mu naught by 4 pi, where mu naught is said to be as the permeability of free space. We are going to discuss about all this in the chapter of magnetism. So in the form of vector notation also, we can write d mu naught by 4 pi I. Between whom and whom this theta angle is there? It is between the dl vector. It is a dl vector because it is having magnitude, and the angle is subtended between r. So if the theta angle is between dl and r, so over here it is written dl bar cross r bar divided by r cube. So if you are going to break it up, what you are going to get? Mod of dl, mod of r sine theta divided by r cube. One r will be cancelled out. So it is idl sine theta divided by r square. In terms of current density, the expression can be written in this way. I will come to this topic later. And in terms of charge and velocity, the expression can be written in this way, mu naught by 4 pi q v bar cross r bar divided by r cube. Why? Just see over here. I into dl is equal to, I can write I in terms of q by dt. Understood everybody? Charge by time. For a small amount of time, suppose q is the amount of the charge moving, so it is q by dt into dl. So q into dl dt. What is dl dt? Displacement by time. Displacement by time gives you what? Instantaneous velocity. So q multiplied by v. So this expression can also be written as mu naught by 4 pi q v bar cross r bar by r cube.